I welcome you all in the next video tutorial of pharmacognosy and phytochemistry 2. So in this video tutorial, we are going to start the resins, that is from the unit number 3, because we have already started the unit number 3 and completed the terpenoids, in which we have completed the menthol, citral and artemisinin, and in the glycoside categories we have completed glycyrrhetinic acid, or we can say glycyrrhizin and rutin, of course. So in this category of resin, we have two phytoconstituents that we have to do the analysis, identification and of course the isolation part. And those two phytoconstituents are podophyllotoxin and curcumin. So let's start. As we know, curcumin is obtained from haldi, Indian saffron, that is Curcuma longa, belonging to the family Gingiberaceae. Here it is, this is the plant of Curcuma longa. And yes, the part used are, you see this photograph, what are the part used of turmeric haldi? Yes, the rhizome part. So curcumin is the main chemical constituent present in the turmeric, and it is an orange yellow crystalline powder. Just see the structure of this curcumin, because its related derivatives like dimethoxy curcumin, that is curcumin 2 is also present, then bis dimethoxy curcumin, that is curcumin 3 is also present. So you have to remember this structure, that is of the curcumin. And look at this formula, C21H20O6. So this is the molecular formula of the curcumin. So here C21H20O6. See again the chemical structure of the curcumin. So let's talk about the extraction procedure. So generally, for the isolation of curcumin, we have to follow different extraction procedures, like solvent extraction method, which is the most convenient method, then the supercritical fluid extraction method. These are the modern methods, like ultrasonic irradiation and microwave assisted extraction. So turmeric powder is subjected to extracted with alcohol in an Soxhlet apparatus. So here it is, this is the Soxhlet apparatus. So where we have to put our drug? Over here in the Soxhlet extraction chamber unit. And I hope you know about this tube and this tube. So this is the siphon tube and this is the side tube. Just see this image, the photograph. This is the side tube, and here it is, this one is the siphon tube. So it fall back again. That's why its method is known as continuous hot extraction method. You will put your solvent in the RBF, and when the desired boiling point is achieved, obviously you will put your drug here. The vapors will rise and it will go in the side tube. It will go in the side tube, and here the condenser is attached. So vapors get converted into liquid state. It falls down into the drug, which is either packed in the thimble or just put above the cotton. Okay, then in this procedure, when the drops of the solvent, they are fallen into the, they go inside the drug, what will happen? Yes, extraction will take place. Penetration of the solvent inside the drug, solubilization of the active constituent, then escape out. And you will see here, this tube will fill now. This is your, yes, siphon tube. And when the solvent will reach at this distance, it will fall again in the RBF due to gravity, like in this way. That's why this method is known as continuous hot extraction, because it is a continuous procedure. So in the very simple method in which we use alcoholic extract and will concentrate it and dried it. Look at the steps now. Yeah, first of all, you will take turmeric, you will powder it. Generally, we used coarse powder for the Soxhlet extraction, and you will subject it to the solvent extraction using Soxhlet apparatus. Then you will concentrate your solvent. Okay, and then you will go for the crystallization. Using an appropriate solvent, you will use crystallization. Then removal of the crystal by using centrifugation. Then you will wash or you can say you purify your crystal by washing, then you will remove the solvent, dry it, and you will find the curcumin in the powder form. So this is very simple procedure. And for the identification and the analysis part, you will go for the TLC studies. TLC method is an appropriate method in which is a stationary phase, yes, silica gel G. And which is a mobile phase, you will use chloroform ratio ethanol ratio glycerolic acid in the ratio 94:5:1, means 94 ml chloroform, 5 ml ethanol and 1 ml glycerolic acid. Okay, and you will observe detecting reagent with the help of detecting reagent, that is UV light. You will observe your sample under UV light at 366 nanometer, that is the long UV. And curcumin short RF value of 0.79. There are some identification tests also. That is, you will take your powder drug and then you will treat with sulfuric acid. It will give crimson color. But this test is for the drug. This is not the test for the curcumin. Okay, but you have to remember this test also. This is the test for identification of turmeric, not the curcumin. Okay, second test, when you treat the aqueous solution of the turmeric with boric acid, it will give reddish brown color. Okay, which on addition of alkali changes to greenish blue. So this is again the identification test of the turmeric. So another method for the analysis of the curcumin now, they are also, curcumin is also analyzed by using spectroscopic methods as well as chromatographic methods. Okay, suppose here it is, the HPLC method is used for the analysis of the curcumin, in which we generally use this mobile phase, that is the ethanol column is particularly of the nucleosyl. This is the column material that we used for packing. Then we will generally follow the flow rate at 1.2 ml per liter and detection is done at UV 254 nanometer. Because we know in HPLC we use detectors, different type of detectors. So in this case, detection is done at 254 nanometer. And the curcumin shows the retention time, that is 11 to 12 minutes. So here it is, the curcumin peak retention time is 11 to 12 minutes. So I think this will give you a brief idea about the isolation, identification and the analysis of the curcumin. So in the last, I acknowledge all the sources I have used to prepare this video, especially SciShare, YouTube, Google Images, etc. So thank you for your patience and listening. See you in the next lecture.